I am absolutely saddened by what I am witnessing in Washington, D.C. Now that Congress certified the election of Joe Biden for president of the United States, I am watching people who are supposed to be allies of the president abandon him. They are using the security breach of the Capitol yesterday as an excuse to hang the violence around the neck of the president in some futile effort to save their own behinds, I guess. It's a desperate self-serving attempt to distance themselves from a man they should continue to embrace. Take a look at these high-level Trump staffers who have already quit their post today. Transportation Secretary Elaine Chao. She's the wife of Mitch McConnell, no surprise, right? Another weakling running for cover. The president's envoy to Northern Ireland and former budget director Mick Mulvaney. He quit. The president's deputy press secretary, Sarah Matthews, also packed it in. There are others too. These defectors are the very reason I always warned the president's biggest threat has always been from the inside and an inability to be confident about who he can trust. Like Lindsey Graham, a supporter when it's easy, but he folds to media pressure, I guess.
When it comes to accountability, the president needs to understand that his actions were the problem, not the solution.
All right, so now establishment Republicans, the very people despised by Trump supporters, are pouncing, exploiting the security breach for their own gain.
What happened here today was an insurrection incited by the President of the United States. Those who choose to continue to support his dangerous gambit by objecting to the results of a legitimate democratic election will forever be seen as being complicit in an unprecedented attack against our democracy.
The only one complicit is him. An insurrection, he says? A legitimate election? I don't think so. Only a few hundred out of tens of thousands of peaceful protesters actually made it inside. Nearly all of them were unarmed. And though I will never defend their actions, it is not what those who suffer from Trump derangement syndrome are making it out to be.
Now, January 6th will go down as one of the darkest days in recent American history. A final warning to our nation about the consequences of a demagogic president.
One of the darkest days in American history, Senator Chuck Schumer declares. What about September 11th or Pearl Harbor? The Oklahoma City bombing? What about the riots that we saw unfold over the past year in liberal city after liberal city? Those days were far darker, and the left never condemned the rioting in those cities. The destruction of personal property, livelihoods lost, murders, looting. In fact, those on the left didn't even do what President Trump did. Ask people to stop and go home.
You have to go home now. We have to have peace. We have to have law and order. We have to respect our great people in law and order. We don't want anybody hurt.
The president sincerely wanted the violence to stop. He asked people to remain peaceful. But I need to remind you of how the left acts. This is what we got during the height of the Antifa BLM riots.
They're not going to stop. They're not going to stop. And that's, they're not, this is a movement. Everyone beware. They're not going to let up, and they should not. And we should not.
There needs to be unrest in the streets for as long as there is unrest in our lives.
If you see anybody from that cabinet in a restaurant, in a department store, at a gasoline station, you get out and you create a crowd. And you push back on them. And you tell them they're not welcome anymore, anywhere.
I just don't even know why there aren't uprisings all over the country. Maybe there will be.
Again, let me be very clear here. I don't condone what happened inside the people's house, but the reactions to the violence and destruction should at least be equal. I watched angry Americans gather on the steps of the Capitol. A very few broke windows and busted down doors. Those protesters should be arrested, but they didn't set fires like we saw in Kenosha. They didn't spray paint century-old paintings or torch cars like they did in Minneapolis. They didn't topple police cars or throw Molotov cocktails like they did in Portland. Here is what they did do. They created such chaos, it led to a woman being shot. A 14-year Air Force veteran, by all accounts, a Trump-loving patriot whose emotions overtook her. She can be seen here in the top right of the screen just before the shot is fired. Why she chooses to jump through that window after being warned armed officers were on the other side, I have no idea. But the overall reaction to this tragic day, compared to so many others, doesn't make sense until you quickly realize it's all about President Trump.
I call for the vice president and members of the cabinet to ensure the next few weeks are safe for the American people and that we have a sane captain of the ship. It's time to invoke the 25th Amendment and to end this nightmare.
Well, that's a Republican, a so-called one anyway, joining Nancy Pelosi, AOC, and the rest of the left-wing loons, calling to have the president removed from office any way possible. I would ask this to anyone criticizing the president today. How else did you want him to handle it? I'm not sure anyone could have prevented what happened, except, of course, for the perpetrators themselves.